Guys, the hair's a little Thor-ish today. It feels very big. I washed it just for this video. What's going on, guys? My name is Chris Howe, and on this week's episode, we're talking about how to become friends with celebrities or famous people using your skill set as a photographer. Now, I'm gonna be sharing with you a story of how Russell Wilson, who is a quarterback for the Seattle Seahawks, if you guys don't follow football, quickly like Google his name. He's won a Super Bowl. He's kind of a big deal in the football world. So essentially, you're gonna be telling a story about him and I became friends, and you guys guessed it, yes, it involves a camera. So I'm gonna be sharing a few little tips at the end of this video on how you guys can become friends with different musicians, actors, or famous YouTubers, or maybe just somebody at your school or your workplace that you wanna become friends with. So on that note, let's jump into a how-to tutorial. So a few weeks ago, I was at this event in Gimli, Manitoba with Mercedes-Benz, where we were essentially drifting cars on a frozen lake. And one of the people that ended up showing up at this event was Russell Wilson, this football player. Pretty much the last person you would think would show up in the middle of nowhere Canada to go drive cars, but he was there and he was with his wife, Sierra. And if you guys don't know who Sierra is, she's the girl who sang 1-2-Step. So the two of them were here for this event. And while I was out taking photos of the cars and the different people who were participating, I quickly ran up to Russell Wilson while everyone was playing hockey. I thought this would be a great opportunity. He loves sports. Maybe he would love a photo of him playing hockey. So I ran up to Russell. I was like, yo, Russell, like stand over here where the light was like absolutely perfect. The whole day was like overcast and like, it just kind of felt like that one moment where he was playing hockey, everything like opened up and they're like, perfect light. So anyways, I was like, go stand in the perfect light. And I took this photo of him playing hockey and I was like, kind of like stand like this, do this, do this. And then I quickly ran back to my room after I took that photo, threw it on my computer, downloaded it, edited it, then sent it right back to my phone because I knew Russell was gonna be leaving in about a half an hour. So I ran back downstairs. I had the photo ready on my phone to airdrop him at any moment just in case he liked it. So he was saying his final goodbyes to everyone and I ran up and I said, hey Russell, I ended up taking this photo of you earlier today. I think you really, really like it. He's like, yeah man, show it to me. So I showed him the photo. He's like, dude, this photo is fire. Text that to me right now. And I was like, of course, Russell Wilson, quarterback for the Seattle Seahawks. I will text that to you right now. Just give me your number. So he gave me his number. I threw it in my phone. I texted him the photo, but I also included a quick little sentence along with it. I said, hey Russell, this is at the Chris Howe, the photographer from the Gimli, Manitoba event with Mercedes-Benz. It was a pleasure working with you today. I look forward to hopefully working with you again in the future. So because I put at the Chris Howe, Russell ended up going and checking out my Instagram page. He's like, yo man, I just checked out your Instagram page. Absolutely love it. I love your work. Please stay in touch. I would love to collaborate with you on some future stuff. I think you're an amazing photographer. I was like, thank you, Russell Wilson. You're so kind and so nice to me over text. So essentially we've been corresponding back and forth since then. He ended up posting my photo on Instagram, but because I put at the Chris Howe, he properly tagged it. So this is how essentially our friendship started, is because of this one photo that I took. So you guys might be thinking, oh, Chris, you're at this Mercedes event. You're like, you're always gonna be around celebrities and this is not fair. Where would I ever meet celebrities? Well, I'm gonna leave you with a few tips if you guys wanna become friends with famous people. So tip number one is to go where the celebrities go. So a few years back, I was a volunteer on a radio station called The Todd Shapiro Show on Sirius XM. And essentially I just reached out to him, said, hey, I'd love to help you out on your show. I can like produce content and take photos or maybe even make some like fun little radio ads, just whatever skill set I had as a content creator to help this show. So the host of the show said, yes, I'd love to have you on. And because I was in a place where celebrities are constantly going through because they're promoting a book or an event or whatever it is that they're promoting, maybe it's a movie, you're constantly meeting different celebrities. So go and find the different places where celebrities go. And often that's TV stations, radio stations, or even just follow them on Twitter to find out maybe if they're in your city or not. And then maybe you can go meet up with them if they end up doing a meetup or something along those lines. And in that case, that's your opportunity to go and take a photo of them. Tip number two is if you want to take a photo of them that they're going to share or that they'll like, or maybe will build the relationship, research their Instagram page or wherever they end up posting or on YouTube or whatever it ends up being. Research the type of photos that they post so that your photo fits in line with their Instagram page and actually maybe like bring different materials or props along so you guys can actually take a really dope photo together. Let's say you're at the radio station. We'll go and find a dope spot or bring along a cool item to put in the photo so that when they actually get that photo, like, yo, this photo is sweet. You really thought this out because you had a location in mind or you brought some lighting along, or you prepared for that photo so that when you actually send them the photo and show them the photo, they're actually gonna like it. Tip number three, and I guess this could kind of go anywhere, is just don't fangirl when you meet these people. Don't treat them like celebrities. Treat them like a normal person or a friend, because if you wanna become friends with them, friends don't fangirl. You can be polite and be like, hey, Russell, you know, congratulations on an amazing career. It's very inspirational, but don't be just like, oh my God, Russell Wilson, oh, it's so nice to meet you. You've been an inspiration my whole entire life. Is it hot in here? It's pretty hot in here. Oh, you're hot. I mean, no, what? Anyways, don't do things like that. Treat them like a person, treat them like a friend, because they'll respect you for that. And I know it might be hard, especially if you really love what they do, but trust me, just act normal around them and that will end up building the friendship and relationship and maybe something that will lead into a lifelong friendship. Tip number four is timing is everything. So if you take this photo, you can't take a week to edit it and then send it to them. Take the photo, get it on your laptop, edit it right away, have it on your phone or on your laptop to airdrop them or email them at any given moment. And before they leave, make the effort to go up to them. I know it can be scary to go and approach celebrities, but they're just normal people. So run up to them, say, hey, just wanted to give you a heads up. I took this really cool photo of you. I thought you might like it. And if you show it to them and they're like, hey, this is pretty cool. Maybe send it to my management. Well, at least go and send it to your management. But if they really like it and it's a really good photo, often they need to post their own content to their Instagram pages or Twitter or wherever it ends up being. So make it available for airdrop or for text or for email right away and send it to them the moment they ask for it. And then tip number five is the power of suggestion. So in that text with Russell Wilson, I actually put my username on there so that he could go and find it. If you don't put that, they're not gonna know who to tag and how to find you. And when they post, they're just gonna be like, too busy, and they might forget to credit you or tag you. So make sure that you let them know that you either want a credit or maybe just subtly be like, here's my username in case you like want to credit it for your photo, but no pressure, I understand if you have a certain theme going on your page. So be respectful of what they want, but also the power of suggestion. All right, those are my tips to how to become friends with different celebrities or famous people. If you guys saw some value in this video, please press like, it actually makes a difference. Subscribe, would love for you to join along, and we're gonna catch you in the next video. Peace out, everybody. Woo!